أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله أحمده تعالى وأستعين به وأستغفره وأستهديه وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. في سورة يوسف we're about to finish this surah, the interpretation of the surah. In verse number 103, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a very strong statement. After all of this story, why? Because the Jewish people, they went to the people of Mecca and they told them, go ask Muhammad about the story of Joseph. And they knew it, it is in the Torah. So what happened is, they asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him this surah one shot, the whole entire surah together, big surah. And the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, oh, that's good. Why is good? Because maybe they're going to listen to this surah chapter in details and they're going to believe and they're going to be mu'mineen. That's it. After I give them all of these proofs and these evidences that the Quran, it is from Allah, it is not from me. And I give them details about the life of Prophet Joseph, which is these details, it was not in the Torah or the Bible. Means, Al-Quran Al-Kareem gives Ahsan Al-Qasas, more details about the story of Joseph from the beginning to the end. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after all of this, Anba'il Ghaib, the unseen, which is Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was not aware about it. And Al-Ghaib, two types of Ghaib, Ghaib Nisbi, Ghaib Mutlaq. Ghaib Nisbi, the unseen, that kind of Ghaib, unseen. Nisbi means somebody can know part of it while you don't know Muhammad. For example, those who used to live with Joseph, alayhi salam, and around him, and they attended the story and what happened, they used to know about it, which is, it is not completely Ghaib, unseen, because somebody already knows about it, but Rasulullah was not aware about it. The Christian are Jewish. They knew about Surat Yusuf before Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because he was illiterate. He did not know how to read and write. He was not aware about it at all. But the Quran came with the whole entire surah in details to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Means it's a big and strong evidences to these people to tell them this Quran, it is not from Muhammad. It is from Allah Almighty. It is not from Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the Rasul was happy because he said, maybe they're going to believe now. And they denied him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What was the reaction of Rasulullah, as usual, when somebody denied him from his people? He was sad, alayhi salatu wa sallam. And Allah mentioned that in the Quran, in Surah Fatir, one verse, in Surah Al-Kahf, one verse, and too many surahs also. He said, for example, in Surah Al-Kahf, فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ أَثَرِهِمْ إِلَّمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفَ. Why you have a lot of sorrow and the sadness because they deny you? And in Surah Fatir he said, فَلَا تَذْهَبْ نَفْسُكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَسَرَاتٍ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا يَصْنَعُونَ. Why you are so sad? You're gonna die for them because they did not believe in you? Allah knows what they are doing. Your job, ya Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam, just deliver the message in perfect way. And don't worry about them if they believe or not. I will take care of them. Yeah. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the verse number 103, Surah Yusuf, وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسَ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. What is the meaning of this ayah? He said, oh Muhammad, most of our people are not believing or following you, even if you try hard. وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ, to straighten them to the path or to put them in Sirat al-Mustaqim. Most of them, وَمَا أَكْثَرُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned something like that also in different surah. He said, وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ. Most of the people, they will not follow you and they will not believe in you, or Muhammad, even if you try hard to put them in Sirat al-Mustaqim. Another verse said, وَإِنْ تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضُلُّكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. If you obey, O Muhammad, most of the people on the earth, they will misguide you. They will let you go, deviate you from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means, since Adam, until the day of judgment, الكثرة, the most, they're going to be مؤمنين or not مؤمنين. وما أكثر الناس, they will be disbelievers. They're going to be rebellious, evildoers. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was حريص, he was working hard to bring people to Islam and to Iman. Because he loves us. And he knew what we didn't know. He knew what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing for the mu'mineen. And he knew what he is almighty also prepared for the disbelievers or for the rebellious. Verse number 128 in the chapter of Tawbah, last verse actually in this chapter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ. And another recitation said, مِّنْ أَنفَسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِدْتُمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. See, حَرَصْتَ, حَرِيص, working hard for you. حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah has sent a Rasul, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, from amongst you, one from you, من أنفسكم, another recitation, one of the, your best, أنفسكم, and من أنفسكم, one of you, عزيز عليه ما عنتم, makes him sad and in sorrow because you disobey him. حريص عليكم, he cares a lot about you. بالمؤمنين رؤوف الرحيم, he is treating the مؤمنين with رحمة and رأفة, صلى الله عليه وسلم. فرسول عليه السلام, he was one of them. ولكن جحدوا الإيمان وحزن لذلك الأمر صلى الله عليه وسلم. They rejected الإيمان, the faith. And رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم was sad. Why? Because he was expecting them to believe in him after all of these details, analysis of Surat Yusuf. This is not from me. I'm not aware about that. ذلك من أنباء الغيب نوحيه إليك. The same thing, the story of Noah. Allah said also, ذلك من أنباء الغيب نوحيه إليك. About Maryam too, ذلك من أنباء الغيب نوحيه إليك. موسى, وما كنت بجانب الغربي. موسى عليه السلام. For see, all of these stories from الغيب, the unseen. Rasulullah was not aware about Musa, what happened to him, Maryam, what happened to her, Joseph, what happened to him. It's all unseen for Rasulullah. And when Rasulullah came with this in details, means, guys, believe in the Quran. Quran is a book of Allah, it is not from me. But they still denying because their nafs was khabisa and their hearts was bad. They did not accept al-Iman because their hearts was not really open, was tightened, you know, locked their hearts. Why? Because they love dunya. They follow their desires and they have hatred and kibr. Subhanallah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was working hard for these people to believe what they are not. They were not. Allah said, verse 100, number 4, verse number 104, وَمَا تَسْأَلُهُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ وَمَا تَسْأَلُهُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And they said, Allah, وَمَا تَسْأَلُهُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ. Don't ask them for a payment, O Muhammad. Or another meaning, Rasulullah never asked them for a payment, like al-ahbar wal-ruhban wal-kuhan, like the preachers and the monks and all these people. They used to take some payments from people, even if it is less, not too much. Khalil, but Rasulullah never asked for any payment for his da'wah. Even sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not allow himself and his family to take the sadaqah. Sadaqah is not allowed for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because sadaqah, the charity is from awsakh al-nas, from the dirt of people, dirt of their zinub. Rasulullah, when he saw al-Hasan, his grandson, he found a small date, a little date from the sadaqah, and he tried to take it, to pick it up, to eat it. Rasulullah said, kikh, kikh, kikh. It is not for you. Something fell. See? Fasadaqah is not allowed to Rasulullah and his family. His Ahli al-Bayt, not Ahli Bayti, his Ahli Bayti. His close family, like Ali, Fatima, Hassan, Hussein, and this Ahli Bayt, Uqayl, Abbas, they're not allowed to take Ja'far, they're not allowed to take Sadaqah, but they can accept the gift. Yes, if you give him a gift, we'll take it. Sadaqah, no. For the point here is, Allah said, وَمَا تَسْأَلُهُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ. Do not ask them for payment for our guidance to them, Ya Muhammad. Like the preachers, the ahbar, the rahban, the monks, they are taking money from their people. But Rasulullah never asked for any money. And this sadaqah he did not allow it for himself. In huwa illa dhikrul alameen. This Quran, see, Allah comes to the Quran now after that ayah I said it right now, number 103. Because they must believe in the Quran. If the Quran talks about the story of Yusuf in details, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not aware about it. Or the story of Musa, or the story of Maryam. All of this from the Quran. The Quran comes from the unseen. And Allah said in the Quran al-Kareem, Rasulullah did not ask for any payments for this guidance or for this hidayah to them. But the Quran, what? It is in huwa, the Holy Quran, it is dhikrul alameen. It is the Holy Quran, it is guidance and reminder for all mankind. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this ayah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just to tell him, Ya Muhammad, you have, alayhi salatu wasalam, you have very high position, Ya Muhammad. Don't ask for dunya. Leave the dunya to them. You have very high position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Quran, it is a way of happiness for them, sa'ad for them, success for them. But these people, they are still rejecting that. And if you give them the Quran of Muhammad without any payment, without anything, this is to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the way of delivering the message and da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this Quran, which is we are reciting day and night, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, and Rasulullah SAW was reciting the Quran to the Sahaba, tazkir wa'idha, reminder, admonition, very strong admonition in the Quran. Hidayah, guidance for all mankind. What do they mean, all mankind? It is not for certain tribe or certain people in certain country, in certain jinns, male or female, or no. The Quran for the jinn and the ins, al-alamin, alam al-ins wa alam al-jinn. Al-jinn, they listen to the Quran before even al-sahab. The people of Mecca, they rejected the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was reciting the Quran to them. For the Quran, it's a hidayah for the ins and for the jinn. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to benefit us all from the Holy Quran.
Ameen.
And to make it a way for us to go to Jannah, inshallah.
Ameen.
And a way of guidance and hidayah and reminder and a good admonition for Muslims. Ameen. To get the benefit and the shifa and the maw'izah from this Quran, inshallah. Ameen. As I said just right now, when Rasulullah was delivering the Quran to the people of Mecca, they rejected the Quran. Who was listening to the Quran first? Al-jinn. And Allah mentioned that in Surah Al-Jinn. قُلْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ أَنَّهُ اسْتَمَعَ نَفَرٌ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ فَقَالُوا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا قُرْآنًا عَجَبًا يَهْدِي إِلَى الرُّشْدِ فَآمَنَّا بِهِ وَلَنْ نُشْرِكَ بِرَبِّنَا أَحَدًا وَأَنَّهُ تَعَالَى جَدُّ رَبِّنَا مَا اتَّخَذَ صَاحِبَةً وَلَا وَلَدًا. سبحان الله. فالجن, they've been listening to the Quran, they reflected to the Quran even before the human being. When Allah سبحانه وتعالى revealed Surah Ar-Rahman, عروس القرآن, the bride of the Quran. It's a weak hadith, but I love it. Surah Ar-Rahman. And Allah said, فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. The jinn, they were blind to the ayah before the Sahaba. And the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, I wonder. The jinn, they understood the ayah and they said, وَلَا نُكَذِّبُ بِشَيْءٍ مِنْ نِعْمِكَ يَا رَبِّ فَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ وَلَكَ الشُّكْرِ. The jinn was replying when Allah said, he repeated too many times in the ayah. فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَ تُكَذِّبَانِ. Which of Allah's blessings and bounties are you denying? Al-jinn, they said, Ya Rabb, we never deny any one of your blessings. And we praise you. فَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ وَلَكَ الشُّكْرُ يَا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And the Sahaba, they were sitting like this. What is this? And the Rasul was mad. Said, Al-jinn, they understand and they reply before you. فَالْجِنْ also, they accepted the Quran even before the human being. But that's why the Quran for al-ins wal-jinn.